Thanks for joining us today for another video from Howard Piano Industries. Today we're going to be continuing our study about piano tuning theory. This is part three in the piano tuning theory video series. And today we're going to be studying and learning about what are called beats. In piano tuning, it's important to understand what beats are so that you can listen for the correct things in tuning the notes. In our previous videos, we had first talked about the notes and intervals on a piano, and then we talked about partials in the video part two. But today we're going to be talking about beats. Now, what beats are, if we think about the notes on a piano and how they're sound waves. Okay, so you've got this sound wave here that for each particular note, and of course it goes very quickly. For example, the A above middle C or A4, that they say that's usually tuned to 440. Okay, what that means is that it waves 440 times per second, which is very fast. Okay, and those waves are what create the sound. Okay, now on a piano, if you've probably noticed, there's more than one string for each individual note. Okay, we're going to be showing some examples of beats, what beats sound like from unisons. Okay, so we're going to be comparing two strings of the same note. Okay, and what happens is, what beats are, they're created when you've got two waves, okay, or in this case we've got two strings that are both vibrating, and theoretically if we want them to sound in tune, they both have to be vibrating at the exact same speed. Okay, I'm going to be using A3 here as an example. Okay, and if those two strings aren't completely or exactly in tune with each other, you're going to have an audible, what's what they call a beat, okay, or a wave, okay. But those waves, if one beats just a little bit faster than the other, those waves aren't going to be happening at the exact same time, which causes the beats. Okay. Now here I'm going to show you an example, and hopefully you can hear it. It does take some practice to get to where you can actually hear the beats, but that's what you want to be practicing, being able to listen for and hear when you're learning to tune a piano. Okay, so here I've got A3, which is the A below middle C, and I've muted off the right string, so I've only got the middle string and the left string of A3 able to be sounded. Okay, and I've got it tuned so the left string is just a little bit flat of the middle string. Okay, and you might if you've got a good ear, you might recognize that. Oh, that's just a little bit out of tune. Okay, now I'll show you what that beat. I'll show you where that beat is. Okay, so I don't know if you can hear that in the video, but it's just a little bit off. Okay, now I'm going to play middle C or C4. So, you know, that one's fairly well in tune. Now I'll go ahead put the right string out of tune just a little bit. I've muted the left string on C4. There's your beat right there. Okay, so being able to listen for those, okay, you start by being able to recognize them on unisons. But if we take that C4, and what I'll do now, I'll pull it into tune so that I remove the beat. Okay, so now here it's nice and even, so you don't have the beat there. So that's what beats are, a pretty basic concept, but it takes some time and some practice to learn how to hear them, listen for them, and from there, we're going to continue our tuning study, because being able to hear those beats is very crucial and instrumental, and be able to tune by ear. If you have any questions, feel free to visit our website, howardpianoindustries.com.